Hi, my name is Lucia Rodriguez Perez. I'm a visual artist. I'm from Chile. I was born and raised in Santiago, and I moved to New York in 2014, and I'm currently based in Brooklyn, New York. I was lucky to grow up in a household where my parents, especially my mom, really encouraged us to like look into art and like do some art. I had a lot of siblings, so I think that she liked that we could like stand still, you know, like sit for a second. But also like they had like an appreciation for it, and most of my siblings have some sort of artistic inclination. When I was 12, I took a class in school of like acrylic painting. And I really felt drawn to painting. And I think that that's pretty much the first step that I took to commit to more of an artistic practice. And then later in life, more of like as an adult, I felt drawn to art because I felt that it would give me a lot of flexibility and freedom to explore ideas that I had and not necessarily just to have to develop like a product for somebody else. I think a lot of it has to do with thinking through making. In that line, I think what I've been like finding that is useful for me is look for inspiration in the world, taking pictures, making sketches, seeing what's out there that inspires me. I think that color is one of the main elements that guide my creative process. Color is a language in itself, but very different from conceptual or like a language-based language. And I think that that allows for an ambiguity and a freedom that we can't find in other ways. I think I didn't realize for a long time that I had a huge affinity with color. I thought that my main medium of expression was drawing when I was like a teenager and early in my art education. And then I realized that I really like working with color. When I took this class on color in my undergrad with a really good professor, Eduardo Vilches, and he did a really good job communicating that to us, and I started feeling like maybe there's something about color that I'm interested in. I realized that color is everything for me. It's like it gives me all the options that I want, and it became like this kind of guidance in the developing of my work. So usually what I would do, I have an idea in mind, I would do some sketches in my iPad, but then I would do a little study in which I would try different pigments, I would write them down, and I would try the main color relationships to get an idea of how light can work before I go into the painting. For me, one of the difficult things about painting is that while you paint, you're doing a lot of things at the same time. You're drawing, you're working with color, you're working with composition, and you're working with substance. So in some way, I try to break down that process so I can work on all those different elements separately. So when I get to the painting, I have kind of like a path that I've designed for myself, and I can solve the little things that come up as I work without feeling overwhelmed by the total. You need to start forgetting what you're looking at in terms of like that's a person or that's a plant or that's a chair. So you need to think about angles and lines and shapes. So one of the things that I started doing in school was working with plants as my models, because I felt that plants have this perfect relationship between being figurative and abstract. Like each leaf is like a plane that it's like placed in space in a specific way. And also plants move over time. So in a way they force me to be flexible. So for a long time I worked with plants as models. Over time I abandoned that idea. I started working with color and composition in other ways, but recently I've been feeling the need to reincorporate the plants. Something that I like about plants, especially these ideas of like ivies and fields of leaves, is that they can hide things very effectively, but also they create very interesting planes of depth in very shallow spaces. So in this painting that I'm working on right now, I'm reincorporating the plants and I want to make them interact with these patterns that I'm working with. One of the things that I like about that is that the plants are much more organic shapes. They're more soft, and in a way they reinforce the pattern and the hardness of the pattern. And they reinforce each other in terms of substance. So I have this pattern that is more firm, that is almost like an architectural feature. And then I have the plants that are organic and grow in their own little patterns. I used to be really hard on myself because you have an expectation and like an idea of what you want to do. And you need to understand that your work is the process in which you're going to hopefully achieve that goal. And you're ultimately never going to be 100% satisfied, or you would stop making work. I'm really excited about the idea of taking my paintings into the space. I would always keep painting because I want to keep painting, and painting is an important language for me. But I would love to have the chance to develop an installation, probably like in a whole gallery or in a whole room, where there could be paintings, but also like installation objects, creating an experience that is physical, where you can like almost like walk into one of my paintings.